saying, I'm just thinking that one out of the two that people will just one again. I already know that we can't go beyond one. And that one will be enough. You know? If we give you too much, you will forget. And it will be of no use. So let's be digesting them one. And that's why I'm not teaching on Wednesday, because if you have too much information, is no information. You'll be taking it little by little, chew. You know, you will break it down, you know. If it makes you cry, cry. There's nothing wrong with cry. And if it makes you laugh, laugh. There's nothing wrong with it. But make sure you find full expression in the presence of God. Because healing comes through all of those expressions. And my God will never forsake you. Amen. Okay, today, we've been talking about boundaries and sins. And who can remember the first thing we have talked about? Number one?
Financial.
Number two?
Relational.
Number three? Prosperity. You know, prosperity. Remember we're talking about prosperity? Well, many things happen last week, so we don't remember the topic anymore. Many things happen, so we don't know what to say. We're asked to this part of it. Today, we're talking about entitlement mentality sin. Entitlement mentality sin. There are people today whose blessings and future and prosperity and the good have been lost because of their attitude. And that attitude is what? That mentality is called entitlement mentality. That's an attitude, right? That's an attitude. Somebody with entitlement mentality tells you that he thinks that people are I deserve it. I'm entitled to it after all. It is expected. He said before God. He said even this is not even enough. It's entitled. It's my entitlement. It's my birthright. If I don't have to do what I'm seeing, it's not there yet. An entitlement mentality says you owe me something. You don't know where you're going to go, but that's his or her attitude. You owe me something. It encourages him to demand that you do something for me. In other words, if I have an entitlement attitude, it encourages me to constantly demand, do something for me, for me, for me, for me. It's about me. Give me something. Treat me in a unique or special way. You can't treat him the way you treat everybody. Even if you dash everybody back and you dash him, as everybody has done, it's nothing. Because he thinks he's special. And he won't have to be different and special. And very well customized. Yes, he does. And it's mine. It's an entitlement. And I will not go back. But you know what? When you have to. Is forgotten. Entitlement mentality is exposed.
Hello.
Somebody did not get what I said.
Hello.
When what?
Gratitude.
Gratitude is forgotten. You know, because sometimes people do things when you forgot to say thank you. You forgot to appreciate. I mean, we have different ways of appreciating, but somebody can just, you just forget. Why? Because of something. You don't just forget that somebody did something for you. When they do it, it touches you, you feel happy. It makes you smile if your head was down. As when they will tell you, wow, you start that beating of smile shows, I'm happy, I'm glad, I'm grateful. But when you forget it, you know what is exposed, what they call entitlement. You know why you forget it? Because you think you deserve something better than what you're seeing. When gratitude is neglected, entitlement is what? Exposed. Is exposed. If you look at the scriptures, Mark chapter 10, verse 39 to about 40 and even down, there are some two brothers called James and John. They call them the sons of Zebedee. They have been very close to Jesus Christ. They were his friends. They were always there. They came to a point where they began to feel that they were entitled and the natural is theirs. They couldn't have been any other person. And entitlement gets to a point where you become like a foolish person. You know, they saw Jesus as a point and they asked Jesus. and they say, we want to ask for something. We want you to do something. In fact, the way he says, we want you to do for us whatever we ask. Can I check that please? I don't make a presentation. That's what I was saying. I've never seen something like that before. You go to somebody, you see that somebody comes to office and says that, I want you to do for me whatever, or anything I ask. Did you see my hand? Very open. That is harassment, you see, in another country. You will sue for harassment. How will you tell somebody, I want you to do whatever? Do you understand English?
Yeah.
Whatever, anything I ask for, and you know you should do it. If for you all this year, this is the time for, what do they call it? Time for pay or what?
Pay
time. Pay time. So whatever, anything I ask. When I read it, I believe that the diversity of the Spirit. Say, whatever. Who are you, even if it's your father? And the first song, you can't sit before him and say, I want you to do whatever. And sometimes, some people will call it faith. But I call it witchcraft. Because you go to those churches, they will tell you, when you bring the handkerchief, do it on his face. Anything you ask, he'll give you. That's not faith. That's what we can do. That's stupidity. That's witchcraft. You come to somebody, you put your hand and say, I want you to do for me whatever I ask. Whatever I ask. He has been so entitled that he thinks that Jesus owes him so much for following him around. If you have a problem, that's the way you appeal to someone, say, please, if it pleases you, I'm in trouble, they not be answered. You appeal to the person for the when you come and say, I want you to do, and in fact, that kind of comment, the person will put his hand in his pocket. Whatever. But that's the attitude of people with entitlement. Mentality, you know. So, now let's get down the scripture. When they ask Jesus, what did Jesus say? Jesus said, "What? What is it you want, baby? Let me be your witness." And they said, "Jesus, it's simple. You can do it, and you have to do it. We're only two. I'll be following you, closest to you. You know that we're closest. You know we're your best friend. We don't have one other than any other person. I don't want to have to use you know, because we know." He said, when you enter your glory, I don't mean now but for me, something when it's finished and everything is gathered, you enter your glory. He doesn't mean that all to wait and believe. That's our problem with you. He said, when you enter your glory and you are settled, I want to be at your right hand and my brother at your left hand. What stupidity. People like this with an entitlement mentality. They don't even remember that Jesus has a mother and a father. If you stay on the left, your brother on the right, grab his wife's name.
Okay.
If he had a they don't care if there is anyone. They keep there at the one. Where you go with the new one. They don't care about any other person. They are simply the most important person. They are the most hardworking person. They are the most desired person. And that is the lie of the devil. Anytime you begin to see yourself as more important, the Bible says we should prepare one another in love. Make it assume that others are better placed than you. You don't take that honorable place. You say, if you go to a place, don't struggle to go to the front. Find a place behind. And if that chance they decide to bring you to the front, thank God. You don't access the most important place. Say, put me. And Jesus said, is that so? He said, well, if you drink of the cup that I drink from, or I think of the baptism that I baptize, or then you may get it. And before you drink, the Lord knows what he's talking about, the suffering, crucifixion, the difficulties he's going to do. He said that they not the people, the natural mentality don't have brain in their head.
Hello.
Before you finish, he said, we have, and you know that we have suffered more than you. Just okay, we're not arguing that. However, even though you can break up the cup and baptize for the same baptism, the issue of who will be on the left or the right is not within my power.
sir.
Somebody is capable who will place things that were there. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
When Jesus was crucified, who was on the left and the right? I'm Robert. I'm Robert. Are you from
Yes, sir.
When Jesus died, apparently, he was glorified, and I'm coming today. Who said he's sitting on the right? Paul. If you look at Jesus before you look at Paul said, Paul said. Was Paul available when Jesus was alive? He was not in the fellowship. He was not in the church at all. But he's the one that is truly on the right of Jesus.
Yes.
I need to read what I'm saying. Is somebody in church this morning?
Yes, sir.
I want you to open your hearts. Because I want to expose something to you that can take you for the next 30 years.
Amen.
And if you understand that there are barriers, you can break and begin to live your life again.
Yes.
This is not a normal Sunday message. I just want to drop something for you.
Yeah.
It's neither John nor James. Paul. He said, I am in the midst of the apostles. They said, for you to be back to the apostles, you have to be there, you have to see all the very bad work, but Paul did not see any. It is not in my power. I don't know, except by revelation, whether Jesus had any other than any Paul, I'm sure. Except by revelation. He was sincere when he was telling him, it's not in my power to determine who will be on the left or on the right. There were those who were trying to place themselves, but they do not know what they do. Now, Jesus said, if you can do it, man. Jesus said, if you can drink of the cup, fine, but it's not in my power. Then he went down. He said, those of you who want to be the head, you have to be the slave. And those of you who want to be the person, you have to be the servant of all. In other words, he said, as a matter of fact, it is end. It is end. Not by length of time you have been the friend of Jesus Christ. Not by heart. It is end. God is the one that has the marking scheme. There are things you end. He's not just giving to you because it's you, or because you manipulated the way to it. He's giving. And he appreciates it. That's what happened there. Said somebody, it is end.
It is end.
Have you ended it? That's the question you should ask yourself. Have you ended it? Entitlement blinds your eye from gratitude. What you think you desire corrupts your mind from appreciating what you are giving. Entitlement blinds your eye from gratitude. That's the relationship between entitlement and gratitude. As I smile at the many people that never have gratitude, that I can watch. The real thing is the denial of entitlement and exposure of ingratitude. When you can't find it, to thank, it is because of your fear that you qualify for it, overqualify for it. So I said, entitlement blinds your eye from gratitude. What you think you deserve corrupts. You know what it means to corrupt? Corrupts your mind from appreciating what you're doing. You know what corruption means? Because of you in chemistry and all of that, corruption. When you see all these white sins, those for the beauty are early, grab those acclaimed white sins. You know, and you think it's going to start like that forever. When rain beats it and dust comes and heat comes, corrosion takes place. There's a chemical reaction that after when it's finished, it changes. It sometimes happens in some people's body. You see somebody that used to be you know, and then all of a sudden after some time it becomes a black person. It happens when those who have entitlement mentality sit down in the house as boss. Looking at the girls, they don't appreciate them. And then some jungle boys will come and pull them and go. Some of them, after some years, those that were white will become black. Because it's a jungle person that took him. The person that is meant for is there. Looking for somebody who paid bright price for him and give him a free one.
Come on.
And you're not the judge yet.
Hey! Hey!
People who have had the word of God. Pay the right, do everything for them, and then they say that is faith. And then a jungle man comes over and says, he knows it's meant for Boys, are you church?
Yeah.
Do like this. This mentality, they never be my portion.
It
makes you think that it's your father's responsibility to marry a wife and give you. So a proper person will pass. You just stay here. So they bring it to you. Nobody will bring wife for you. So open your eyes, never know. Nobody will bring
you.
If you are dumb, you will die.
Think of it by yourself. Somebody has made a company for billions upon billions, and the day he leaves,
not a route to prosperity. Somebody didn't hear me this morning. In John chapter 6, from verse 1 to 4. You know this story again. I said it last Sunday. Jesus went out with his disciples and it became night. They were hungry. And he saw they were hungry, they need to give them food. But the disciples advised Jesus Christ. And they said to him, what do you want to do in this wilderness? That to feed these people, it's not this small stuff is here that we are not to give us. We have the exhaustions in the pot, bring it down now. Are you afraid of bringing it up? Judas is there in the pot, bring it up. He said, we need half a year wages if we are going to feed this. So it has to be raw money to bring it up. That's the advice of giving Jesus Christ. If you really, if you want, they say, if you want to eat, they say, if you want to eat a frog, eat a fat one. They were telling Jesus that's the secret of that advice that gave Jesus Christ. You need to give money. At least half, let me not give that I said half a year's salary. Is there a possibility? Half a year, bring it. Half a year wages. And to make it worse, I think it was Peter that came from God said, well, you know, they were just making caricature. If you don't want to eat, let us eat too. Peter said, well, you don't want to bring out the money. There's something here, something like that, five loaves. It's to make caricature of him because you know that as soon as he comes out, five loaves and two fish, how far can he go? He told him and concluded that you know that he cannot do anything. You know the reaction of Jesus Christ. Did you say you have five loaves and two fishes? As much as five and two fishes. Can you place it in my hand? You know, to show you that prosperity is not what you have or who you are. That's why Jesus said, place it in my hand. Don't stop Jesus from saying, the little child holding this is where you are, please. Stop breaking it. Bring it to school at least can go around. You know, he didn't say that. Okay, he didn't give it to the disciples so that the disciples can bring it. He said, bring it.
Yes, sir.
Bring
yes, sir.
It. Can you release that? Now listen. When it was placed in the master's hands, the status of that bread changed.
Yes.
The reason you're spending money and spending on something not wrong is because of your hands.
I hear you.
Because of your hands.
I hear you.
Even if it's 1 million that is placed there,
6 months.
Your hands, not just your brain, not just your mind, your attitude. When Jesus picked that five loaves and two fishes and thought you begin to intercede. I thought you begin to chant. In the name of Jesus, the Son of God, I command these five loaves and two fishes. I command you, multiply. And in Lazarus' grave, he prayed.
He said,
Except your moment, I didn't see one prayer anywhere in any of the translation that Jesus did of that prayer. Did you see anywhere he prayed?
No.
He did not say one prayer. He did not open his mouth and say, Lord, give us a miracle of this prayer.
Yes.
If you are thinking, Lord, it's your prayer that is thinking, it's your prayer that is telling you, if you never prayed at all,
ever.
All he said is, Lord, place it in my hands. I'm going to do this for you. And let's see how it will be done. Your hand is not the same with mine, neither your brain with mine, nor your future with mine.
My God.
Jesus understood the issue of food and devil. There are people you should eat for. Say this one. Put it in my hands. First. What did Jesus do? Father, I took it. That's all we did. And after he did that, what did he do next? Now, that is okay. Come, make them sit down. Now we need to break it. And as he's breaking it, it was not standing. And they were breaking it. And he never said one prayer. Father, we will be ready for you. You know that we need to be ready. And the has to be food. Oh, come on. You know that the poor man. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. He didn't do anything like that. He gave what?
Tax.
He gave tax. So much of it remain, and we are told it's 12 baskets. And what did he tell them? He said, collect the 12 baskets, let nothing be wasted. You know what he's telling them there? I did not come all the way from heaven to be multiplying food for instead of instead. That's not my mission. I'm sure it's to do the will of him that sent me. My mission, my means to do the will of him that sent me and accomplish it. And to accomplish it. The devil tried to turn stone story to bread. He knew that. That's not what he's called to do. Some of us have come to specialize in food. Don't specialize in multiplying. That's not what he's doing. Those are not the miracles he came to do. He came to reconcile the world to God. Because no matter how much food you eat, it will not take you to heaven. No matter how much money you get, it will not take you to heaven. Heaven is free. Heaven is free. If you do not fulfill the conditions for righteousness, you will die in hell. And if you go and give you food every day, you will still go to hell. He said, the 12% keep it carefully because it's not this kind of prayer I'll be praying every day. He said, handle it very well. And know by yourself how you can produce it. What gets me into that? That's why he said that. Go through the scripture and say, how many places? How many places of missing is that we do?
Yes,
sir. Some of us have become apostles of truth.
Hello.
Because of the pressure of life. And we yield. What we do as ministers is to yield to the pressure.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And we need to talk like Aaron. Moses had not just stayed 40 days up yet. Aaron already yielded. A great man of God, he yielded to the pressure. And he did a cup for the hand of your worship and said, hey, this man is good that he can touch and heal. I like this kind of God. He said, whatever you need, some of us are now stagnated with a city because we can't be grateful for simple gifts.
Hello.
I want you to open your heart, don't think of any other person. What was that? It was some way just out of I have this message was sent. I didn't want to comment so much. Many of us have been stagnated with a ceiling we are talking about because we can't be grateful for simple gifts. We can't be grateful for simple gifts. We don't have the right to select your gifts, except the gifts came in the house telling you to do like this or do like this. A gift is a gift.
Yes, sir.
Big or small. A gift is what?
It's a gift.
You don't want that, you don't want that. And what do you say?
Thank you.
Be grateful. And be grateful to God. If somebody tells you, tell me, I'll say, what car do you want? I'll say, what do you say? What car do I want? What car do I want? I'll make you poor. I call the name of one car. When you finish, you don't have any. You know what I'm saying? But there are times that are just waste.
Yes.
They don't have too much, they don't know what to do with it. They just waste it. You spend billions to buy one car and you can only carry one person. Get two extra passengers. Because they tell you it's your world, then your own world, you don't need a second person. And the best is a second person. So they say three is a crowd. If it's me, I'm wise enough to say, you need a car. I want to buy you a car. I'll ask you what range. Let me know what you will have, so that I will know what to choose from. I want to come within your purposes, so I don't stretch you unnecessarily. I don't want you to give me a gift and you go back paying money. So I'll ask you what is the range of funds you have. If you tell me it's 10 million, I know the car that I will need 10 million. If you say it's 5 million, I know the car that I will need 5 million. If you say it's 100 million, I know the cars that are going to be 100 million. And if you also say it's 500 thousand, I will consult and I know where to get to that thousand. There's always a range. It's not you that determine the size of your gift, it's the giver. That's why you must be grateful for whatsoever anybody has given into you. You know, one day like that, some days ago, a lady walked into my office. I And she walked, I can't remember if she's been there before, I don't remember. And she came, I sat down, wow, what are you here? She said, you know, I like to say so many things, gratitude. You know, you've always been there, you've done this, that, that, that. I'm just a grateful heart. Just to come and say, I may not have car, I may not have this, I may not have that, but I recognize that God has used to do this and do this, and you could feel, her heart. And then when she finished, she was having something long like this, with that polythene cover. So, she was like giving it to me, and in my mind, I said, this must be customized holding umbrella. If it has to be umbrella, I thought, this is like, this must be an umbrella. To bring umbrella to me because we are customized with my name and picture of it. You know that kind of thing. They're gonna open it. You know what is inside it? Sugar cane. I don't know why you're laughing. You're laughing for different things. But I'm sorry. I'm expecting customized. If it has to be umbrella, I have to be a good one. Because he said, I cannot buy you a car. What's in the way you want? Please use this umbrella. The car is your picture. You know that kind of thing. I received it with 2 minutes after that. And I said, thank you. And when I looked at this weapon, it was so called fresh, clean, top and clean, as if polished, rich. You know, there's weapon and there's weapon. This is the right one that was thrown here, you know. I used to eat it those days and say, no, I don't eat it again, not because it's bad. I don't want to damage my teeth, I want to put it on. Anything hard, even if it's meat, if it's hard, I bless it and leave it there. But if you give me our connect, there's always someone whose teeth is stronger than mine.
Yes.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? Always, 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 like always. I receive good two hands. I can't eat sugar cane. Not that I can't eat that again, I just want to preserve my teeth. So I was excited. Somebody came to me and the gift you give me is what? Sugar cane. I said, let's interpret it. At least I'm prepared to get my vitamin. At least it has not sense. I prepare sugar cane now. Always see something good about someone.
Yes, sir.
I can't believe that. So I took it. Pray with her, and I was happy. She said that when I wish she left, I knew what the polythene is. Polythene has made this thing that is, give me my meat. Put it on my table. Everyone reports as a gift, give my meat. Something like that. Somebody really came here and gave me this as a gift. Yes. What is wrong with it? Then I began to call. By the time I finished, the atmosphere in my office changed. Everybody came. Do you know that she came not wrong with you? People asked, it was broken down, it was not enough. As they were eating, the water was increasing. It was sweet because people were happy and almost forever with it. Sugar cane. I told him how happy. We started to talk a lot. You see how people will sit there and say, you know I'm poor, you know I don't have anything, but when I'm brewing you, your body is bringing oil, you don't have anything, then you can give to another person that will be pastor. You cannot share something with someone. She said, no, there is no such person around who cannot share something. She walked in there to say, those of you who think your own is to get and to eat, what other people brought you, you have the responsibility. Somebody. Now, I sat to her and this time she came.
Yeah.
Where she came, she had to use transport. The transport is not an issue again.
Yeah.
I don't have to do that right. The transport is not an issue again.
Yes, sir.
And she could send message to go all that way and put her hands. She didn't ask me whether I ate sugar cane. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Because even if she asked me, I would say yes. A gift is meant to be received. That's what Saul was told. When they bring those people, don't say that they don't eat no, they eat cake, sure. You say receive it from their hands. Don't say it's cake they eat. Those who eat great things, they don't make noise about it.
Mm-hmm.
It's for people who make noise about what they eat and what they drink. Ah, they're giving me back now. I think wine, I just want you to know that this one. And even the one, there's a special one. And you have to buy from a special place. That is all nonsense. It's people who are coming from wrong ends without education and then stumbling to want to behave like that.
Yeah.
Say they will wash their hands with with 5 and 9. That's rubbish. Absolute nonsense. Mm. Because there's no work. That's why you have to start a lot of worship. The issue is not to listen to them. No.
Oh!
Mm. Where are those pastors? Where are they?
Where are they?
At 60 million, with 5 million, 50 million. Where are they? Okay. Because there's nothing in the heaven.
Realness.
There's nothing
in the head.
She changed the atmosphere in my office that day. I just took over the job. Everybody was happy. And people greeted in and said, some of them you could see like I've been foolish all this while, waiting for when I can have money to buy a car. And you would die, not buying for yourself, not going back to the numbers. And when you go to heaven, they say you didn't have the capacity to share. And yet Paul said it is more blessed to give. There's nobody who doesn't have something he can share.
Nobody.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
And it melted my heart with joy. Are you hearing what?
Yes, sir.
Why people are really just saying they got 20,000? Also, on Monday, I got 1,000. Somebody gave me a charge card, and I was happy with it. I don't have to say what you want, but I'm going to be here. People give me 200 charge. Enter them, come, oh, enter them, I just want to. So my brother, I sit and I receive it at the end and with gratitude. People are giving me 1 million and I also receive it. There's no bigger gratitude or smaller one.
Hey, well, I hear you, sir.
Hey. I hear you. I receive 1 million and I receive 1 million. The same gratitude. You know why? Because the reason somebody who feels entitled is feeling entitled is because I. If I was thinking about myself as nothing that should be paid, I don't even think there's any condition for me to reject in the first place. But if I was just thinking of myself, look at people enjoying this. This is special should be paid. And it's special because I made it special.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I made it special.
Yes, sir.
When people give you things, it's not always for you. Somebody may be giving you something because he knows you know something. Are you here? That's why I said, if you look at the kind, you say, give me a kind, you cheat yourself, cheat your family, cheat your generation. Because there's no kind of doubt about that. You know what I'm doing with it? There are people around me who are not giving one before. They'll be happy to receive it. Bishop Festus has a house in UK, has all kinds of things. The first car he drove was a car somebody gave out to the church, that was a donate car. There's never going to forget to buy any car. And all he does is to shift to those that can appreciate it. He drove Volkswagen 1,300. Then the second one, Volkswagen 1,500. Third one, Pigeon, that people give because a new one comes, since they gave Pigeon, you that have this, give to that person. That's how it works. If you say give me a car, those cars also receive. If somebody says, how can you give a man that drives customized cars? They both put his own pictures, put his name and everything. What car will you give him? They lose out. Lose out. They're not people. Are you?
Yes, sir.
My daughter gave me money, not because she knows I'm not going to do this. She's giving to you truly because she thinks I'll be wise to know who needs this money. After it goes through. And if I'm thinking of my own needs and love it, then I'm finished. I'm finished. 90% of what I have received has come out of them. 90%. So there's nothing that is not good. There's nothing. Why? God from heaven knows that you will let it go to who wants it. And that's why it's going to be. And when you stop it, it's foolishness, it's selfishness. Selfishness, that's what I'm saying.
Yes, sir.
You know, still important. We have this problem in Nigeria, the feeling of importance. You give impression you are rich, give impression you are too much. Really? That's what we see now in Nigeria.
Yes, sir.
Those who are wealthy, they will tell you, sir. They get a lot of these people, they drive this truck. A truck, they move about, they have billions, they drive themselves everywhere they want to. When you see them, you will not lose the gate.
Exactly.
I said, this is the gate, the richest man in the world, not me. in the shape of what you came with yourself.
Yeah.
How many authorities and drivers that are following you around? The person that needs protection is moving about freely because you don't go anywhere. But the person who is a prisoner has to be.
I'm a prisoner. I hear you, sir.
That's what I'm saying.
Yes, sir.
We have a false attitude. Hypocritical attitude. We are not real.
Yes, sir.
Because our life is difficult.
Yes, sir.
You don't eat what you want to eat, but you want to give the people the impression that you are eating expensive meals after you are borrowing. You want to wear that people that they look at you and say, wow, he's really a rich person.
Mm-hmm.
After you go behind, you are borrowing money. That's false life. That's the beginning of feeding.
I hear you, sir.
Because when people see you living luxuriously, even if they have something that will happen, they will know, because they will know this man that is, I know I cannot, it's not for this kind of people. And when you suffer, you suffer alone. Because of the impressions you give. I was passing through my friend's house, and he had beautiful shoes. You know that was very beautiful shoes. The wife just told us, this man, these are new shoes, he wore this one once and drop. The thing is here, in our church, they are too proud. They just want to do things. And that church, see the person didn't wash it, all his dirt is done. But he doesn't want you to give him what he's used to. He needs help, but he's not even help.
I hear you, sir.
The people, how come they could have shared? They're not sharing because they don't want to be insulted. They're passing the church, they can't give them a brand new shoe. Because it's not on his side. They will say he goes to America, this is not from America. I want to work at this one from the back end, written there in America. So because the man wasn't going to be insulted, and they kept the shoes in the house. And they told mama, is there anybody in our church? This B, you know, the professor's big leg and everything. So I can't even wear. I told before he finished, my wife told me to walk back in the classes. But no one will bring it. I have people, please. And he didn't take one day and then they closed them. I have done that. I'm taking this. We jump. Just clean the dust on it. Somebody is there, killing, pop off. So I pass out more than I know, as if there's more. What happened? Just bring it. I don't feel anything. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
I said, bring it! What do you cause of me? And even if it's because of me, what is wrong with it?
What is wrong?
Why would you pay money for what you can get free? If I do not accept that, not pay money for what you can get free. Not what you force to be free, what you can get free. You understand that? The problem that is killing us is ingratitude to closing our doors. To appreciate all that's above us. My man wrote a book after I can say he gave out 273 complimentary copies. He signed it, he has sold it to different people. Not because he's so rich, but he feels this people have been telling him about his books and everything, he should put it in books. And he was expecting that when they get it, they will come and say, wow, we finally did everything. Not one person. He said, only four. Said that they received what he ended there. To even say, we got what you said, thank you. He was depressed.
Yes, yeah.
And 273, the person who gets it said, only books. Books. Yeah.
Will I eat?
Books. Will I eat? Is it true? Book. One book. You forget that you're not the only one that is getting it. He gave out 273. How will you get profit out of it? I saw no sin. But the person received it in Christ. The man said he paid him so much because he was brought up. The mother always told him, never you lack in these words. Thank you and I am sorry. He popped it into the head. If you don't know any other thing, thank you and I am sorry. You will need it in your marriage, need it in your relationship,
yes,
you need to travel far.
Yes,
and he has grown. It is difficult to relate to those who cannot say it.
Yes, sir.
And that's why I said that the rich and the poor are always having problems because it's a mentality that the world has. It's a mentality that the poor have. Gratitude, for instance, this man now realizes that he can keep as friends who cannot say I'm sorry and they cannot say thank you.
Yes,
sir. Keep them as friends. We'll keep on having problems, we'll keep on having heartbreak.
Yes, sir.
You want somebody to acknowledge what you give, you cannot even be acknowledged.
Yeah.
I mean, just say that I got it. I got it. I reserved my comments. At least I got it. I reserved my comments. I got it. And then if you attend you to it. A wise person will say, if you don't have time to read, you know, you just get say, oh, wonderful. You eventually put it that it's nice. It's like the package is good. And you don't want to tell lies. But then that is somebody who is wise will go to and find a blessing out of it and share with the person who will be able to useful to me. Hello.
Hi.
Are you following what I'm saying this morning?
Yes, sir.
I don't know what it's doing to you. Is it getting you angry or?
Oh.
You are learning something. Are you learning something?
Yes, sir.
When people give you a gift, receive it at their hand with gratitude. With gratitude. I remember in our wedding we had so much gifts as we were there. It filled the whole room. Some of the days we are repeated, but we love them, we see them and back. But you know, as the years went on, many people were doing well. Sometimes you don't even remember. We just enter that room, boom, remove all the wrappings and the addresses and gifts. We're giving it until everything is almost gone.
Yes, sir.
It's not always for you.
Yes, sir.
Are you hearing what I'm
saying? I hear you, sir.
I visited a family some years ago. As I entered the house, when I was entering through the gate, as I was coming in, the little boy in the house, as soon as he came out of the house, I saw him. He didn't like it. Wanted to enter the house. Came back. I didn't even know what is going on. Then finally, he went and saw a flower. Come on, flower. And quickly gave it to me. When I collected it, he realized. That's his own gift. As far as it's concerned, a little child, you don't meet a prophet and don't let something be. He's the God's your education. I hear what I'm saying.
Yes,
the moment he came to me, he realized. And I carried that stick, leaning in front. I didn't tell the boy, I'm not a good at this news. Next time, tell your mother to bring chicken, eh? Is somebody hearing
me? I hear you, sir. Hallelujah.
I carried that stick with me when I was going. I carefully carried it. I know why I carefully carried it. Because I appreciate what the guy has done. He has done something prophetic for the parents to see. And the parents were busy watching him. But God was trying to use him to show them how to treat their prophet. When he was doing that, of the spirit of the Lord. I didn't throw it to me, I carried it. But I was doing a little bit. That's not gifts. I'm not good. But it's a gift.
It's a gift.
Hello?
Hallelujah.
The secret of multiplication is gratitude. And when you think, and what you think for will likely multiply. What you thank for will likely multiply. That's the secret of thanksgiving. I said, the secret of multiplication is gratitude. What you thank for will likely multiply. What you thank for will likely multiply. What you thank for will do what? Likely multiply. What you thank for will do what? Likely multiply. And I said, that's the reason we do thanksgiving service. Thanksgiving service is not contrary to what we say and do. Well, you know, God has blessed you and you have your harvest. No. It means my brother and my sister, what you have cannot take you anywhere.
Yes, sir.
Before you eat your seed, take it to the Lord. And when you put it down, you have positioned yourself for the future. Multiplication. That's how we do that. That's how we do that. And that's how, you know, when Jesus brought that bread, I said, Lord, I give you that. You know what that bread is? Father, I thank you because even in this way that it's found it necessary to make sure there is a boy having 5 loaves and 2 fish. Ah, Father, we thank you that there was no bread at all in this place. Supposing there was none at all. That's why he's thanking you. And that's the reason why it multiplied. He could have said, Father, you know that these disciples, it's not enough. I want this, they eat very well. People, disciples, it's not going to do anything for them. But Father, do the miracle, the man of miracle. In the way that I thought of the manner, do it again. That's why we don't see miracles.
Hey! Hey!
He said, Father, even this one, I'm grateful. In this wilderness, 5 whole loaves of bread. In the wilderness, 2 fishes. How the listening to is even available. That's why you are blind. The secret of multiplication is what?
That's the spirit.
In our church, not something for those that were there. Somebody's child was poor. For just 20,000. I'm sure she has seen hundreds of thousands. At least she has seen 100,000. But 20,000 was poor. And the depth of her thought and connection, she landed on the ground, rolling and rolling and rolling. I stood there and said, was it one good? Did you need 7 million? 20,000. Rolling on the ground. Rolling on the ground. Oh God. Oh God. The shackles are broken. You don't understand.
Hey.
You don't understand. Rolling on the ground. Because of 20. And you think it's just that 20. And don't just open. Because God cannot walk into your life and your life will never be. And he sat down and saw the way the cross had buried in hell and his knee is landed. I can see Jesus right here with me. You have not said that you understood that God is dead. As the visitations will come.
Amen.
I was having the name of the daughter of the son or something like that and started to cry. And then she started to speak a language that was not her mother language. That lady is from Benin, but she was speaking Hebrew. Or Hindi. Chineke or Hindi. You know what I mean? No, is that how you are? I've been around with you for some 20 years now. But is that how you are, oh God? Is that how you are? Is that how you are? Is that how you are? Is that how she was crying? Nobody could console her.
Yes, sir.
And what she was doing, the person she was talking to was, oh my God. You see this little thing? This little thing? Okay. Hey! Stop up! My God! Like you said, I'm only the finger of God. I'm uncomfortable. I have this style. What do I give it? Is that how you act, sister? Is that how you act? It's the best. It's the best. And then, another person brought 10,000. And we asked him, who are you giving? Who are you giving 10,000? Is that how you act? Is that how you act? The finger of God will come, the leg of God will come, the nose of God will come, and the brain will come.
Yes, sir.
The people that are going to say, hey, stop, no. Let's learn to allow people to enjoy the presence of God and not remove it from them. Excess of entitlement will lead you to believing so after you got saved, your life closed because you are feeling entitled. You are feeling entitled. It's man. That's why you struggle. If you don't manipulate it, it doesn't come. If you don't tell somebody a story to manipulate it, nothing comes to you. You always find story. I don't tell people a story to manipulate it. I've never. I will suggest it to you. If you don't remember me, you're losing your blessing. God has to put it in your head for you to bring your blessing. If I manipulate you, you don't get any blessing. That's good for us. I said, a sense of entitlement will lead you to believing success should be handed over to you. In turn, this prevents you from taking action and working on building it for yourself. That's the difference between the North and the South. It makes you think you built enough, but the road in front is no God, it's the government will do it. No matter how you do, government will do it. In front of your house, what are you doing? What are you doing? Put toilets in your house. Yes? What are they doing in my mouth? That's what I'm entitled to the person. It's always like, what are they doing with this? For those making progress, it's giving you like it's whatever you're doing with your own, but I'm moving ahead. People with entitlement mentality always find out what is inside. They can't go around, they will finish their waiting for pension before they build their house. Why? The government is supposed to build it. And that's what the government is doing.
Government assets thing.
That's the problem with the government of. That is good in it, but those who are doing it are not good. Those who go out to build their future, they keep doing it because they don't know what is coming to help them.
Yes, sir.
That's why you can think everything a blessed man has, he will still get rich again.
I hear you. Just
you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to come out of God and say, take everything I have in my Bible and throw it into your wilderness and I'll say, come and prosper. That's what Abraham told God. Take whatever you want. I'll say, come out prosperous. Abraham's mentality is not a freaking mentality. There's nothing wrong. If God puts you to give me, give me. But you know, don't have that attitude of looking for people you receive from. Be the one doing the giving. That's why Abraham said that they wanted to give me, like, no, I want to buy the land of my own.
Right.
I'm not the one, I'm not suffering. I want to pay for it. But some of the kinds of people we have today, they're looking for such good things. There's nothing wrong with it, you can get it. Nothing wrong with it. But it won't make you rich, it will make you prosperous. They're just a little better than the beggar on the road. In fact, beggars are wise, but they're looking at their job. They're not making investments because they know those investments are going to bring them their profits. But those begging are not bringing them. It doesn't matter how much you give. Begging doesn't. So I'll give you just three characters. I have 19. I'll give you three today. Maybe on midweek. I'm not teaching on midweek. I'll just read out a little course so that we can continue where we start. You know, we started from the Matthew 2 part of the Stephen has now. So all I will do is maybe I'll bring like 3 or so. I don't want to give you too much. How do you know? I want you to use it to test yourself. What kind of person am I? Am I also an entitlement person? Before you sit down and think, is that your best sister?
Yes, sir.
Or you are the one.
Yes, sir.
So I'll take time to give this to read out 19. I'll give you probably 2 of them this morning and then we'll close the book. This is the character of entitlement people. Number one, when you find yourself treating those who don't do what you want exactly how you want it. When you treat those who don't do what you want and exactly how you want it badly, either by putting them down or gossiping or a range of other punishments. By the way, I took this psychologist, I just brought up his name. I'm just reading that, that's what I'm telling you, read that. It's not going to work, I work on personalities. So people who have entitlement behaviors, this is one character they have. You treat those who don't do what you want. In other words, entitlement has always wanted to do what they want, the way they want it. So if you don't do it, you treat those who don't do what you want, exactly how you want, you treat them badly. Either by putting them down, you insult them, you want people to disrespect them, you gossip about them, or a range of other punishments, you're punishing them. You know, even people who are not going to punish someone who is ahead of them, they think they can do that. You know, That's what people do. That's what people do to government. You know? Later, when you want to come for election, we will show you. That's how they behave. So he will leave not because he wants to leave for you, but because he wants to get another vote. That's not normal. So when you want to force people to do what they didn't plan to do, what they don't want to do, what have you done? You use this lesson and you don't get any richer. You just feel good that you are now a great man and you made him give you 1 million and you got the 1 million. Wonderful, God for him. So do you have that attitude? That's attitude number one. When you punish people who don't do what you want simply because they didn't do what you want, so you give them unnecessary punishment. That's what we're saying here. If you make things difficult for them simply because they could not live up to the expectation that you want from them, or they could not give you that which you expected to have, so you begin to treat them with disrespect. You don't want to honor them. You begin to do things to show that they are not happy with them. Number two, feeling as if they're automatically a priority in any situation for no apparent reason. Whenever you feel automatically you are a priority in any given situation, whether it's in your office or in church or in your family, a family of seven people, you get angry when they're giving out because you think they should report special giving something that is unique. You are suffering from entitlement mentality. Feeling as if you are automatically a priority in any given situation for no apparent reason. You are not satisfied. What everybody is getting, you just feel you should be different. They talk the last one for now. You are self-serving and will do whatever it takes to get what you want, even if that means at the expense of others. You are self-serving and will do whatever it takes to get what you want, even if that means at the expense of others. You are self-serving and you can do whatever it takes to get what you want, even if that means at the expense of others. I just hope you understand what these things mean, at the expense of others. You don't really care how somebody you are dealing with feels, so long as they are extracting what you want, you are going to have. Your job is that you have been able to extract it, manipulate it, actually steal what you are doing. Do you know many of us are armed robbers, even in the house of God? The difference does not go with God. We're armed robbers. When you pass that before somebody and say you must do this, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Somebody have entered in my office before and said they went to this bishop in the night and they got how many dollars, they went to that place. The person walked from behind from the road through this place and was this doctor's image. I said, look at this place, that's where they hit my head. He's a hard guy. As he was talking, if you're not careful, fear will kill you. And whatever he says, he will do it. He told me, call the names of the people. Pastors, they have visited, they took whatever they want to take. And who are you? They are not the what they want. When you finish something like that, I said, for me to bring this Christ to die his baby, I'm not afraid of death. I want to tell you that. I've had all the things you said, but I don't have all the things. I have it, but I refuse to do it. Do you know when you saw what I said to die his baby, whether you come by 2 a.m. or by 3 a.m., I'm not going to lose one time. And if it's not that time, you cannot accept. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
When they intimidate you, they humiliate you, and out of fear, he said, please don't come in the night. Come with life. And let's move that next. For me to live is Christ, to die is gain. Why are you living? What are you begging now? You're begging. Robin, why do you like to steal him?
Yeah, he's begging.
Why do you like to steal him? Why do you want to scam him with debt? So what I strongly read this is to be able to overcome the trials and temptations of this life. So I will not finish preaching because then I'll be a castaway. What we should be looking for is to go to heaven. If all the righteous conditions are, let us fulfill it so that we don't lose it. But it can't frighten me with death. Because when I die, I will be able to lose it. That guy was hard. I almost felt there was something entered in India. I looked at my husband. You know, eventually he begged me for transport.
my God.
I gave him 100 naira. I walked back from where he came. And later I had passports, I matched with all of them, had the entire like that, and collected everything they had. You can't take what I have, you know. I don't need nobody to help me. You will die! Anybody who tries it, it's finished. But when they intimidate you, fear. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Fear grips. But some Christians are armed robbers. Those that you don't know with guns. When you are busy extracting from people that what they have lived on, you are extracting by force. What is the difference? Rise on your feet. For the people who want to pray, I want you to sincerely, I have taken only one point because I want people to think, I want people to reflect, I want people to meditate. There are characters for pity that is not of God. And the reward you thought you're getting is not a reward. You are just getting what a criminal will get. Criminals also pray before they go. I have read that I let them bring their door and they put it down and they tell somebody to please pray for them.
Thank you.
find your way into the presence of God. So that we can be changed. Some of us are not yet changed. We are not yet Christians. Even though we are preaching. Because if you are, the way you think will be affected. And therefore the way you act will be affected. I'm not saying that people who are going to heaven are affected, no, by any means. They're just simple people that have allowed their hearts to be altered by the presence of God. I know things are difficult, and it's survival of the fittest, and everybody is looking for ways of getting more. All our prayers and fasting is filled with what we get. What is God's word? The Bible says, seek him first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And if you see all this, just pull me. Sometimes they become too much to start to divide them into other people's houses. It's simply your task. When you worship, when you enter his presence, when you decide to know him and your heart is changed, your thoughts and prayer will be changed. I just want to be with you. Now, don't be in the moment as you sing now. I just want to be with you.
Sickness to melt away from your body right now
was the one that they whipped. He was the one that has two things. That his stripes were healed. If you believe in him, your body will heal. I command every sickness in your body, from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, I crush them and I command them to leave you and go in the name of Jesus. Also, let me be barriers in your body. I pray that this week there will be a visitation.
Very good.